This video tutorial will introduce you to fast pinned reports. Pinned reports are reports that were saved with specific filters, meaning that each time you run the report, the filters will be the same. For example, if you need to see all trust and endowment funds for a specific department for the current fiscal year, you could create a pinned report which would allow you to run this report as often as required without having to reset the filters. PIN reports can be run from the FAST homepage or from the Finance Reporting homepage under the Pinned Reports tab. When you click on the tab, you will see four sections on your screen. My Favorite Reports list any report you have marked as a favorite report using the star icon. My Pinned Reports section contains any report that was pinned by you. While Group Pinned Reports contains reports that the administrator of the system have pushed out to a group that you may be a part of, such as research or non-research. All Public Pinned Reports lists pinned reports that everyone has access to. To run a pinned report, simply click on the report's name or click on the green Execute button. The filters of any pinned report will always be detailed at the top of the report. I will now walk you through the process of creating a pinned report by using the example outlined in my introduction. This process can be applied to all available reports. From the Finance Reporting homepage, click on Non-Research Reports at the top of the page and select the Trust and Endowment report. Enter the department filter and click on the function button to select the current fiscal period. It is important to select current fiscal period whenever you plan on pinning a report. Otherwise, each time you run the report, it will only pull in data as of the month and year you had originally entered. Once you have selected the filters by which you wish to run this report from now on, hit the Execute button. If you need to change the layout of the report or add additional column filters, do so before you pin it. For example, I will now move the ending surplus deficit column to the left of the report, making it one of the first columns I see from now on. Furthermore, since I'm only interested in funds that have a surplus greater than 5,000, I will click on the column header, choose Apply Custom Filters, select Greater than 5,000, and finally click Apply Custom Filters. Now that the report has the filters, as well as the look and feel that I want, I'm ready to pin it by clicking on Save As in the bottom right corner of the screen. The next step is to give my pinned report a name. I also have the option of entering a description of the report. The final step is to click on the floppy disk icon to save the pinned report. I know that I have successfully created a pinned report when I see the Report Pinned Successful message on the screen. To run the pinned report, navigate back to the Pinned Report tab. Click on My Pinned Reports, click again on Trust and Endowment, and finally on the report you just created. If you use this report often, you can make it a favorite report by clicking on the star icon. This way, the report will be listed at the top of the Pinned Reports tab and readily available to you. If you wish, you may also add pinned reports to your report tabs. From the Finance Reporting homepage, click on one of the reports available to you at the top of the screen. For example, I will click on Non-Research Reports, Trust and Endowments. I can now see three report tabs at the top of my screen: Filter Options, Help, and the Plus More tab. To add pinned reports as another report tab, I simply click on Plus More and select Edit My Tabs. From there, All I have to do to add the PIN Reports tab is to uncheck the box under the Plus More column and then click Save and Apply Changes. PIN Reports has been added to my report tabs. I can now access and run all of my PIN reports through this tab. This concludes our video tutorial on PIN reports. More video tutorials on the FAST financial reporting tool are available through the Track and the Financial Services websites.